Looking to turn some old cards into new fetch lands? Check out ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We've got ferociously competitive prices on cards new and old, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you'd prefer to pick up singles, boosters, or even a battle box, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order, and soon you'll be rolling in villainous wealth.
Hey everybody, welcome to a modern video. Today I'm going to be playing a modern 8-man event with this deck. I call it Big Zoo. It's a deck that I've been testing in preparation for Grand Prix Oklahoma City, which will probably happen in between the time of recording and the time this video gets posted. So, you know, maybe you can look back and see me have a big finish or possibly bomb out with this Zoo deck. But either way, it's a deck that I've been having a lot of fun testing. It has a lot of strengths in the format and gets to play with a whole lot of really, really great cards that nobody else gets to play with right now. Wild Nacatl, Geist of St. Traft, Knight of the Reliquary, Elspeth, Knight Errant, which is, Elspeth has been the number one greatest reason to play with this deck. Just really, really powerful card, especially when you can get ahead early with a fast deck like Zoo. But anyway, we can talk more about the individual cards as the video progresses. But for now, round one is starting. Like all modern decks, pretty important to be on the play with Zoo here. So this is one of the hands that you're not excited to open on with Zoo. It's pretty important to be able to get a creature out there and start, you know, start beating down. You're not really trying to, it's not like Jund where you're trying to kill everything your opponent plays, so a hand with all removal can sometimes be good. It's more like you want to play a creature and use your removal to force it through blockers over and over again. Or, you know, obviously like against a combo deck, just make sure you don't die to a Glistener Elf or a Deceiver Exarch with Splinter Twin. So anyway, Will I Keep or Will I Mulligan? This hand I could see keeping if I knew the matchup and I was against a creature deck, but against an unknown opponent, it's just, this hand is too bad if they're playing a combo or a control deck, so I'm going to throw it back, try to get a better six. Okay, and this is a much better six, so I'm happy with this. I've been playing a lot of Modern lately. I'm going to be participating in the Modern Super League, which actually should be starting probably around the same time that this video is posted. So definitely, you know, check that out. I think it's going to be a good time. No idea whether I'll be playing this deck or going back to something else or perhaps brewing something new. But either way, you know, I'll be trying my hardest. I'll try to put on a good show for everybody. Okay, so Godless Shrine Duress, and a pretty interesting start off of a Windswept Heath 2. So, I mean, I guess it's probably just an Abzan deck that's playing a whole lot of discard spells and has spilled into playing Duress. Could also be something like Black-White Tokens. But this will only really... I'm obviously playing Voice of Resurgence this turn. It only really affects my decision in as much as I'm deciding what land to fetch for. But I can probably just... I can go for basic forest and then like a Sacred Foundry. Or I could just go for a Stomping Ground and then decide. I'll get a forest because if I draw another land, then maybe I can afford to get a Plains or something. So Voice of Resurgence, very good against the Abzan Jund style decks because Liliana is normally one of the best cards against you. So this is probably a Black-White Tokens deck then, with Tide Hollow Sculler. I'm actually quite happy that my opponent has taken Path to Exile there, because I, number one, don't want to have to path a creature this early, and number two, I don't want to have to play off curve. I really just want to cast the Knight this turn, and this was a really good draw, as I can just kill the Sculler whenever I need to. So I'm going to attack for two, and then fetch a Sacred Foundry. Important to get double white for Elspeth, or if I need to, like, Helix and Path in the same turn. You'll notice Sacred Foundry is the one dual land that I've elected to play two of. It's because I didn't want to play a basic mountain. It's not particularly helpful against Blood Moon and doesn't help cast Voice of Resurgence. So I didn't want to play basic mountain, but I did want to have at least four lands that tap for red mana, which means one of each dual land and then one more, which is a second Sacred Foundry. Well, my opponent has been pretty successful in stifling my aggression here. Oh my. Is he going to cast Raise the Alarm? I could definitely see black-white tokens being a bad matchup for Zoo. Alright, I mean, I guess this is fine. I'm not going to Path to Exile a Soldier token. So let's definitely fetch a red land, Stomping Ground, in case I draw Scavenging Ooze. But hopefully I can just piece together enough burn to kill him with his own Bitter Blossom. It's not going to be real easy. Ooh, especially not with that Vault of the Archangel. Especially not with that Sorin. Wow. How can I possibly win? I guess I'm just going to take this damage and then burn Sorin. Wow, actually, if not for that Sorin, would have been pretty close to winning the game via burn. Why would my opponent play that post-combat? Now's the time I have to cast my spells. Very unlikely to win this game. I'm not even sure if it's possible, if I was to stack my deck. Alright, now I'm definitely dead. So all my opponent has to do is not block here and I'm dead. So, yeah. Concede. So the only thing I could have managed differently that game was my Voice of Resurgence. So I traded it off with the Skuller. But yeah, this definitely seems like one of the harder matchups for me. Thalia is probably pretty nice. Negate. Despite my opponent's deck being virtually all creatures, Negate counters virtually everything. Fracturing Gust destroys Bitter Blossom and the Anthems. Probably just not good enough. Path to Exile was horrible against the cards that my opponent drew that game, but sometimes they could play like Hero of Bladehold and stuff, so let me see exactly how much I have to work with. The Burn is also not that exciting. It's good against Tidehollow Sculler. I think I want all of my creatures. Geist of St. Traft might be one of the weaker ones. So, I wouldn't mind getting those last two Lightning Bolts in. I feel like it's pretty easy for my opponent to deal with the Geist. But maybe not. Maybe if I just get it into play on turn two, it's going to be good enough. Very good with Elspeth, too. Alright, I'll give this a try. Does this do anything? Destroys Tidehollow Sculler. Not that much. Alright. Try it like this. Well, this hand's really good if I draw lands, and my opponent's removal is probably mostly Path to Exile. So I guess I'll just give it a try. If my first draw step is a land, this hand is great, and I'll very likely win. Swamp Deathmark. Duress. Not so bad. Oddly enough, it's a different picture of Duress than he played in the first game, so I know I'm working with multiple Duresses on my opponent's side. Perfect. So I'm going to play the Knight because it's a card that its value increases the longer it's in play. Also, it can help me be a little more explosive. Like, if I draw another creature, the Knight can be a mana accelerator and maybe help me cast all three in the same turn. Or if I draw Elspeth. That's good. So we'll play the Geist and the Lavamancer. I'm drawing very well this game. I mean, I guess only two draw steps, but they've both been pretty close to perfect. Sure. So I'm going to attack with the Geist. It's going to be Exalted. Then I'm going to Lavamancer one of those spirits to make sure my opponent can't activate Windbrisk Heights. Yep. Blocked the 3/3 and not the 4/4. I guess I have the option to wait with the Lavamancer if I want. So a tough matchup for me. If the game goes long, all my opponent's cards are just so powerful, but this is exactly what I need to win, which is just a good fast draw on the play. And this is the real reason that you would choose a deck like Zoo, which is just that, you know, even your bad matchups, you can just get that great Zoo hand and deal 20 damage really quickly. In this case, it's going to have to be 26 damage. Timely Reinforcement's a really good card against me. And, yep, nothing I can really do. I think I'll let my opponent attack if he wants to. No attack. And I'll Lavamancer one of these spirits. So my opponent gets to double block my Geist here, but, or, you know, quadruple block, whatever it might be. But that's fine. Get in 10 damage this way. So what I don't want to see is another Timely Reinforcements. That's the one card that I'm really scared of here. Intangible Virtue. Yeah, I'm fine with that. So that guy, I guess I'm going to burn both the tokens in response. Core Firewalker, actually not that great against my particular build of Zoo. I mean, none of my creatures are red, and it's really just, Grim Lavamancer, but it's really just the burn spells that it makes a difference for. So I'm going to be careful to keep my creature in the graveyard for Tarmogoyf's sake. My opponent is going to have to chump block or else my fetch land and Lavamancer will be enough to finish the game. So another turn of Timely Reinforcements or bust here. Okay. So I take the second game, and now is going to be the hard one where I have to be on the draw. Now, I saw Core Firewalker, but other than that, no real surprises. So, is there any reason to change my sideboarding here? Definitely like the negates. I like all the cheap creatures. Maybe Voice of Resurgence is not that exciting, but it might be better than Lightning Bolt. Let's put that on the shelf for a second. Yeah, I could see the voice not being that good. It's basically just a grizzly bear that my opponent's going to not want to trade with. But that's not super effective here. Especially on the draw when I might be behind. All right, I'll put the bolts back in. I'll leave the voices out. Geist of St. Traff was pretty good that game, but I'm on the draw now. All right. I mean, this build I have in front of me is just kind of maximum aggression, which is a good way to steal games in a matchup that's pretty tough if the game goes long. So go for it. Horrible hand, definite mulligan. Much better. If my opponent has a slow draw, I'm in good shape. Especially if I draw a land that can get me a plains, turn two Thalia here. Could be really disruptive against this type of opponent. It's a fine draw. It's not a plains, but... funny, I actually recently added the breeding pool. Used to be another fetch land, which would have been much better there. So, will I see a raise the alarm or a path to exile here? So, what do I want to play this turn? Thalia, keep my opponent off a 4-drop, like a Planeswalker or a Spectral Procession. A 2-white, 2-color Spectral Procession. But Knight's pretty nice to get in there. Can feed my graveyard for the Lavamancers. I guess I probably just want to play the Knight. See if my opponent paths me also. It's pretty bad for me. But oh well, I can rebuild with the knight, or again, still a tough call. Do I want to play the Thalia and the Lavamancer? That would make a follow-up Spectral Procession pretty bad for me. Alright, yeah, I'll just play the Knight. Get a Stirring Wildwood to start beating down to. Sure, it's not that threatening. That's not that threatening either. At this point, I'm not even sure if I want to draw Wild Nacatls. Alright, so I think I want to just activate my Knight, so I'll attack with Nacatl. And yeah, I'm going to play my Plains because that's probably the land that I want to sacrifice. I'm just going to grab a Stirring Wildwood. It's tempting to want to get the Knight really big, really fast, but I think getting this pretty effective attacker/blocker is a good idea. Wow. So I can cast this if I use the Knight as a mana accelerant. It's a little more tempting to want to play Elspeth when my opponent has mana tapped. So what should I do this turn? Boy, this is a really tough turn. I have a lot of options, including using the Knight or attacking with the Knight. My opponent's down to 10, pretty low life total. I suppose I could just attack with Knight, Nikotle, and Thalia, and Lavamance, one of the fairies, if my opponent tries to double block. However, if I'm doing that, then would it be better to just activate the Wildwood and attack and use the Knight for a red mana instead? Maybe that's what I'll do. What happens if my opponent has another Zealous Persecution? Then Thalia dies, I Lavamance or something in response. My opponent has a 3-3 and gets to eat either my Wildwood or my Nikotle. I mean, it's kind of disastrous, but... Well, I've decided that I don't want to cast Elspeth because I want to use the Lavamancer this turn. All right, Wildwood gets activated. Swing with these guys. All right, that's definitely bad, but it's not the end of the world, I guess. It's going to be a tight game. My opponent, I think, missed a land drop this game, so definitely has spells in hand. Thalia gone, so things are unlocked. Okay, if that's the worst my opponent can do, then maybe I can win this game with Elspeth. Pretty good draw. Probably I just want to attack with both and lightning bolt something. My opponent has to block Knight, sort of has to double block Knight. Guess I'm fine with this. Well, I'm not fine with that. Okay, so Knight is lethal. My opponent's going to need to draw something pretty special here. Like an answer to the Knight, Sorin. So that going to do make a vampire. So now... Now what? I guess I attack and make a soldier with Elspeth. Alternatively, I could... Yeah, I mean, there's not really any alternative. I could search for a Stirring Wildwood. That's not even very helpful. Gonna be a tight game. What's this emblem? Wish I had drawn a non-land card this turn. So options basically are pump the soldier, attack with both, and my opponent will probably trade with the soldier, going to three life, maybe ultimate Sorin. That play would at least beat the board, because then I'd have the Elspeth and I could search for a Wildwood during my upkeep. Other option, just attack with Knight and make a soldier. And then my opponent will have much higher life total. But I'm not really actually getting anywhere if I do that. Well, I'm probably going to lose to almost any instant. But got to make the most of the situation. I don't think I really want to bother attacking Sorin. Yeah, I mean, I'm going to fetch. Just need to pump that Knight. All right. Maybe I'll just draw a Lightning Bolt. That'd be nice. Okay. So on my upkeep, I'll search for Stirring Wildwood. And do I want to sacrifice a Stirring Wildwood? Almost definitely, right? That's only going to be a problem if I draw a 3-mana card. Three mana cards in my deck, Knight and Geist. I guess if I live another turn, I mean, the game's going to be over in 2 turns anyway. Maybe I will just sacrifice the Knight. Not a good draw. All right, I'm just at the mercy of if my opponent has a card. Needs to find one more damage or a way to gain life. this game really going to come down to one life point in either direction? Duress, okay. Coast is clear. One. All right, soldier down. So, does it matter what I do here? Is there a card that gives lifelink? Is there a card that can deal me damage in combat? Is there a way for my opponent to gain life at the end of the turn? I don't see anything mattering, so I'm just going to make a soldier and say go. Wow, what an incredible game. But I do advance to round two. See you there.